In this video, we will review Module 2, Document Control and Policy Management. I will begin this demonstration logged in as a user of the Omni-Assistant. This is a permissions-based software, meaning users see only documents that are pertinent to the departments and roles in which they are assigned. Locate documents easily by simply typing in a keyword. Select the document you wish to read and click to open. Once you've completed your reading, simply close the document. Users may also search for documents using the folders and subfolders or the advanced search function, where they have access to additional filters. A key element of document management is ensuring the tracking of document readings. To the right, we have the Documents and LMS section. Here, each user sees the number of documents pending their reading. Click on the Open to view the list of documents. Select the document you wish to read. The history of change is available if it's been entered. And click on Download to be able to view the document. They read through the associated document. And once complete, each individual has the possibility of including suggestions and comments visible by the document owner. And once they've completed their reading, they simply sign off using their password. This has now been logged in the Omni-Assistant for future reference. This completes the user's perspective. I will now log into the system as a supervisor to show you additional features. I am now logged in as a supervisor. From the homepage, supervisors have access to information related to their role. View your employee status related to the required readings by clicking on the pie chart. This brings you to a list of individuals that you supervise and their related performance. To view the details of a particular individual, click on the Actions button to the left of their name. This brings you to the list of documents pending their reading, so that you can evaluate the risk and determine an appropriate follow-up. Supervisors may also complete the reading logs by clicking on the checkmark of the readings. This brings you to the list of documents that have been completed by your users, so that you can sign off on their readings. Complete the transaction by entering your password. This information is now logged in the Omni-Assistant for future reference. To modify a document under review, select the required document. There are three ways to review a document within the Omni-Assistant. You can renew with or without minor changes, or create a new version. Two kinds of documents can be supported in the Omni-Assistant: those that we consider documents, which are Word, Excel, PowerPoint, etc., or links to URLs, if you choose to include an instructional video, as an example, into your document management system. The description is the title that will be visible to the users when they're searching for documents. The Omni-Assistant automatically attaches the working copy of the previous version for you to work on, or you can click the Modify to browse in your own documents to upload a new document. You may select an effective date, and you can choose to include a unique identifier. This is a field used in the search for documents. Create as many folders or subfolders as are required to organize the documents according to your organization's needs. The document type allows you to define elements related to your specific type of document, such as using the header and footer, review periods of 1 year, 2 years, or as you so wish. You may select a document owner, include any keywords that will help your users in locating the documents. Documents can be associated with one or multiple addresses. select your desired alert related to the periods associated with the document type. We can create automated reactions so that the document owner can receive an email or text message alerting them to the fact that a document is due for review. Here you select the associated readings. Determine who is required to read the document, and then select the type of reading you wish. You may include instructions for your readers, and then determine your follow-up options. You may define late periods for your existing users as well as new users to your department. The Permissions tab is where you would be able to allow individuals or groups of individuals to view the document or have access to modify the document. View your user comments. You can create links to documents within the Omni-Assistant or links to documents outside of the Omni-Assistant or hyperlinks. We maintain the entire approval history from the very first version to the current version for the entire life of the document. You may also choose to include a history of change that will be logged and kept with the version document. Once you've completed these elements, it's possible to use an approval process ticket that can be defined according to the requirements of your approval process. This allows you to include individuals in the approval process without having to give them access to modify the documents. Using the ticketing system to ensure that your approval process is maintained, various individuals as defined by you in your process will receive the ticket to be able to work on the document. The Omni-Assistant automatically attaches the working copy so that the individuals involved in the approval process have access to the document as it has been worked on. We also can include miscellaneous documents to the approval process, such as minutes of a regulating body that approved the document before it can be published. Users can choose to work online or offline. Offline meaning they take the Word document, work on it, and they would need to upload the document back into the ticket, or they can work online using a web-based Word application, which allows people to be able to apply modifications to the document quickly and easily. They can make the modifications required and save. Once completed, they can close this page. The Omni-Assistant automatically attaches the document that was just worked on so that the next individual in the process receives the original as well as the last document that was worked on. Go into the Actions log to identify that your step has been completed, and now the ticket would move to the next individual in the process. The last step of the process is that the document is approved. The Omni-Assistant will automatically bring you to the document modification area so that the document attached can be approved. The last working copy of the ticket will be attached automatically. Here you can see the changes that I applied. You can create a PDF copy directly from this page. And once completed, you may publish the document. Now, any user who is required to read this document has a new document attached on their home page waiting for their reading. This concludes our review of Module 2, Document Control and Policy Management. Please do not hesitate to contact us should you have any questions regarding the Document Control and Policy Management module.